الصلاة هيا على الصلاة هيا على الفلاح هيا على الفلاح
شريك له أن محمد بن عبد الله رب بمحمد الرسول اللهم رب هذه الدعوة لتنصدق من هو بسلة والفضل أبث اللهم ما كمن معمودا الذي يعد إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون نبي الأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إن أحسن الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار عباد الله حديثنا معكم اليوم الكلمات من كلمات القرآن Our khutbah today with you, brothers and sisters, inshallah, we are going to look at some words from the words of the Quran. Al-kalimatul Quran azima, the words of Quran are great. The words of the Quran are important. The words of the Quran have much meaning because they are words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran is a book revealed to us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-kalimatu al-Qur'ani kal-kalimatu al-Islam. The words of the Qur'an like the word al-Islam. Al-Islam meaning the submission to the will of Allah. Kalimatu al-Qur'an kal-kalimatu al-Iman. The words of the Qur'an as the word iman, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-kalimatul Qur'an, kal-kalimatul ihsan, the words of the Qur'an as the word ihsan, to do good deeds. Al-kalimatul Qur'an, kal-kalimatul at-tawheed, the words of Qur'an as the words to tawheed. Al-kalimatul Qur'an, kal-kalimatul al-ilm, the words of the Qur'an as the word of ilm, wisdom. Al-kalimatul Qur'an, kal-kalimatul dhikr, the words of the Qur'an as the word of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kal-kalimatul Qur'an, kal-kalimatul al-istighfar, the word of the Qur'an as the word of istighfar, to ask Allah for forgiveness. And so many other kalimatul Qur'an, kalimatul kathira. There are many words in the Quran, but today, inshallah, what we want to look at is kalima al-ihsan, the word ihsan from the Quran. Al-Ihsan, what is meant by Ihsan? Al-Ihsan, نمثل من حياة كلها. Al-Ihsan gives the example of the whole of our life. The life we lead is all to do with Ihsan. في كل مجلات الحياة, in all aspects of our life, we have to attribute Ihsan. ولم لا, and why not? وقد قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, that in his hadith, إن الله كتب الإحسان على كل شيء, that Allah سبحانه وتعالى had put Ihsan on everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had put Ihsan to everything. Putting Ihsan to everything, kataba, in other words, furida. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it furida to us. Like he says in the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, kutiba alaykum usiyam, kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum. That you believers, Allah has made it compulsory. So it is compulsory for you to fast. So here with Ihsan, again, it is compulsory to us to do good deeds. معنى الإحسان مفهوم, how to understand the word Ihsan, what does it mean? To understand it, Ihsan على كل شيء. Ihsan is on everything. وفي كل شيء, and in everything. We do what? We find Ihsan. إحسان, ترجمات الإحسان, to make the definition of the word إحسان. لا يمكن في أي لغة في العالم, it is not possible in any language in this world, أن تدرك هذه المعاني, to give an example, to define the word إحسان, it is not possible. It's a very big word from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no language where you can do what? Where you can define Ihsan. But we get Ihsan from two words. The first word is Al-Ikhlas. Ikhlas means to do anything when you're doing it in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Ikhlas, to do whatever you do it in the sake of who? Of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. We were not ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do anything except we have to do it إِخْلَاصٌ لِلَّهِ, to do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to وَحِدُ اللَّهِ, you do it for only Allah and not to put any associates with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the other word, وَصَوَاب. أَصَوَاب meaning that whatever you do, you have to do it according to the way the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did it. That is what is meant by Ihsan. We attribute it to do two things. The first one is al-ikhlas, and the second one is sawab, to see that you do all these two things according to, you know that you do it, what you are doing, you do it to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you do it according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you do it ikhlasun lillah. And the second thing, you do it mutaba'atin Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, following the ways of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Those two things are the ones we have to follow whenever we are doing what is known as ikhlas, what is known as ihsan. Because you've said it ihsan, you cannot define it. But the only way you have to define it is to put it in those two things. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Inna salati wa nuski wa mahayaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alamin. This salah we perform here, and the slaughtering of our animals, al-dhabh, and our life here, and our life after, that is when we die, it is all in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is ikhlas lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. So ikhlas lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala is to do whatever you do it to the cause of who? Of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As you can take an example for Allah in the Quran says, wa aqimu salata wa atu zakat. So you have to perform salah. The order is from who? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how do you perform it? For Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي. You pray as you have seen me praying. So Allah gives the order and we get how to do the things from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The same way he says, وَأَتِمُوا الْحَجَّ وَالْأُمْرَ لِلَّهِ. You have to perform your hijjah and umrah for the sake of who? For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet says that, to do with that, he says that, خُذُوا عَنِّي مَنَاسِكَكُمْ. Get your ways of doing the hijjah and umrah from me, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So for here, what we have to understand, for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that we Muslims, on every Friday, we have to be reciting Surah Al-Kahfi. And at the end of Surah Al-Kahfi is where we get these two things. Because here we have to ask ourselves two questions. Limadha wa kaifa. Limadha meaning why. And kaifa meaning how. So limadha, whatever you are going to do in Islam, whatever you are doing in Islam, first you have to ask yourself, why do I do it? Because it was done what? It was given you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do it for the cause of who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's the question you have to ask yourself. Why? And kaifa, how do I do it? You do it as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had to do it. So here, Allah says, فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرُجُ لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ. Whoever thinks that he will go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is on the day of judgment. Because we know, we believers, inshallah, when we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is a chance of seeing Allah. Allah says in the Quran, قُلُوبٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَ. That day, our faces will be happy. When we are going to what? To see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because we have to see Allah on the day of judgment. We believers, not everybody. So, قُلُوبٌ وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَ. وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَ. Our faces on that day will be happy because of what? That is the favor Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give to us, and is the best favor we are going to get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. So, for that ayah, Allah says, فَمَنْ يَرُجُ لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعَمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. That person should do good deeds. Which good deeds? There is where we say kayfiyya. You do it as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to do it. فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكُ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. And he shouldn't associate with his ibadah, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with any associate. So you have to see that whatever you do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't associate him with anything apart from he himself. So there is where you have to get those two pillars. The one we said, you have to ask yourself, why? And the other one you say, you have to do it, kaifiyya, how? Those are the two things you have to do whenever you're doing your ibadah. Alhamdulillah, we can see, as you have understood, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says that, وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. You have to do good deeds because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those people who do good things. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ تَقَوْا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is together with those people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the ones who do good deeds. So these two things, al-ihsan wa taqwa, they are two things which you cannot separate. They move together. Taqwa, to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and ihsan, to do good deeds, those two things move together. Insha'Allah, as Allah says that on the day إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونَ. Those people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be in paradise, in Jannah, on the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had taken us in front of him. He's going to separate us and put us in what? In Jannah. But how are we going to be there? It is because آخذين بما آتاهم ربهم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك محسنين. These people, we are here on earth doing good deeds. Those whoever we are doing good deeds are the ones who will be in Jannah, and they are the ones who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know very well that for Allah says, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ. Tell them that Allah is the ruler of all rulers. تُؤْتِ الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. He, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, gives power to who he wishes. وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءَ. And he removes power to the person he wishes. وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءَ. وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. And he brings down whoever he wants. وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. And he puts up whoever he wants. بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ. In his hands, in Allah's hands, in بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ عَلَى كُلِّ بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءَ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءَ وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءَ وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءَ بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرُ وَعَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. In Allah's hands are good things. From Allah we don't get bad things. Whatever we get from Allah are good things. بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرُ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he only gives us good things. There is nothing bad which comes from Allah. Today we can see we are in fear, the blacks, the Muslims, but what we are fearing, everybody says whatever he does, he wants to say, but for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, he says that, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to test us, and he's testing us with anything, بِشَيْءٍ, anything he wants from himself. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ. The first thing Allah says, that he will bring fear to us. But how are we human beings? Where do we think fear is coming from? And what do we fear? Do we know that this fear is coming from Allah? But for he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ. He is going to test us. مِنَ الْخَوْفِ. First of all, he's going to bring fear. وَالْجُوعِ. He's going to bring hunger. وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ. He's going to take some of our money. وَالْأَنْفُسِ. And he's going to kill some of our people. وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. And he's going to destroy our gardens. The one who does that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But how do we think we people, where do we put these things to? Whom do you think is doing these things? Because everybody, you have to see where these things happened. Everyone was saying whatever he wanted to say. But what do we have to say? For Allah says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Give good news to those people who are patient. Which ones? The ones when such problems come to them, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ. Whenever a problem of this nature comes to them, what do they say? They say, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ. We are all from Allah. وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. And to Allah is where we have to return. So we have to look at ourselves. When all these problems came, who of us had to go back to Allah? Who of us had to say that word? And what did we say? So everybody knows himself. But what we have to say is, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Only that. You don't have to add any other things on it. And if you do that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give you three favors. You're going to get three things from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah says, if you say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, ulaika alayhim salawatu min rabbihim. Those people are the ones who will get blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ulaika alayhim salawatu min rabbihim wa rahma. And they will get even rahma. They will get mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ulaika humul muhtadun. And those are the people who will be guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are the ones who will get guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We go back to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There was a lady, she was called Ummu Salama. Ummu Salama. This lady lost her husband. When she lost her husband, the Prophet Muhammad told her to say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. And again to add on that, Allahumma ajrini fi musibati wa aflifli khayran minha. When she said that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced the best of all best people in this world, who is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by losing his husband, Sufyan, he got محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. وقول قولي هذا صلى الله لي ولكم وسائل المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والآقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له نزل الكتاب وهو يتنزل وهو يتولى الصالحين إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا يقول له كن فيكون فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون سبحانه ما يكون من نجوى الا ما يكون من نجوى ثلاثه الا هو رابعهم ولا خمسه الا هو سادسهم ولا ادنى من ذلك ولا اكثر الا هو معهم اينما كانوا ثم ينبههم بما عملوا يوم القيامه ان الله بكل شيء عليم. عباد الله اوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله كما يوصينا تبارك وتعالى في محكم التنزيل بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. O believers, we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran يا أيها الذين آمنوا O you believers اتق الله fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala حق تقاته in the rightful way of fearing him. ولا تموتن and death shouldn't come to you إلا وأنتم مسلمون except when you have submitted to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is fear? We said that fear and good deeds are two things which are inseparable. You cannot separate them. Fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and doing good deeds, they are two sisters. They are sisters, you cannot separate them. But here, with taqwa, fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from Ali ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, when he was defining the word fear, he said, al-khawfu min al-jalil, is to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-jalil, so that you fear to do whatever small thing which is a sin to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever small it is, don't do it. By doing what? By fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-khawfu min al-jalil. Wal-amalu bit-tanzil. And make sure that whatever you do, your amal, your salah, your zakah, everything you do, make sure that it came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wal-amalu bit-tanzil. Don't do anything you don't know. You have to get knowledge to know that at least what you're doing is from Allah. Wal-amalu bit-tanzil. وَالْقَنَاءُ بِالْكَلِيلِ And you have to satisfy yourself with whatever small thing Allah has given to you. Be satisfied with that. And the last thing he said, وَالْإِسْتِئِدَادُ بِيَوْمِ الرَّحِيلِ And to know that tomorrow, anytime from now, we are going back to who? To Allah. But what have you put in your luggage? What do you have to take to Allah? So you have to see that at least you have good deeds which you are taking with you to Allah. That is to make yourself ready for that trip, because it's a very big trip, so you have to know what you're taking with you. وَالْقَنَاءُ بِالْكَلِيلِ وَالْإِسْتِئْدَادُ بِيَوْمِ الرَّحِيلِ Back to our point, Al-Ihsan, for, as we say, that we cannot translate it, but for our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, مَعَنَ الْإِحْسَانِ because in Islam, Deen al-Islam, we have three steps, three maratib al-Islam. The first one is Islam itself. That is the first step. The second step is al-Iman. And the third step is Ihsan. So it means that Ihsan is the step which is over all these three steps. It is the highest step in Deen al-Islam. So al-Ihsan, for the Prophet said, أن تعبد الله is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala كأنك تراه as if you are seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فإن لم تكن تراه if you see that you don't see Allah فإنه يراك Allah is seeing you. So whatever you do, you have to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing you, because he is Al-Basir, As-Sami'u. He sees and he hears. He is here with us. If we say he's here with us, it doesn't mean that Allah is in every place. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with his knowledge, is here with us. But he is seated on his what? On his arshi. For the Prophet Muhammad sallam say, it tells us that Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his angels, they pray for our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you believers, sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. You should pray for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you should say salam to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So for the disciples of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba, they told him that, and saying that, okay, we know how we can say assalamu alayka ya Rasulullahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but how do we pray for you? For the Prophet said that you have to pray for me Salatul Ibrahimiyya, by saying Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka Hamidum Majid wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim fil alamin innaka Hamidum Majid. Allahumma izzil Islam wal Muslimin. Allahumma izzil Islam wal Muslimin wa dammir a'da' ad-din. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكن من الخاسرين. ربي هب لي من الصالحين. ربي اغفر لي ولوالدي وارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تهول به بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهين به علينا مصائب الدنيا. وما تئنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا أبدا ما بقيتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثمن ظلمنا، وانصرنا على من عادانا، ولا تجعل دون اكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا الى النار مصيرنا، واجعل الجنه هي دارنا، ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. ربنا ظلمنا انفسنا وان لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكن خاسرين. ربي هب لي من الصالحين. ربنا تقبل منا انك انت السميع العليم، وتوب علينا يا مولانا انك التواب الرحيم. وصلي اللهم على محمد وعلى اله وسلم. سبحان ربك رب السماوات والسلام والسلام والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقم الصلاة إن الصلاة من كتابا موقوتا.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الشر ولا إله.